some of my old dream journal entries. As you may know, I'm very fascinated with dreams. I've been recording them for a very long time. I was cleaning out my room just 2 days ago, and I stumbled upon a whole bundle of these. It's from 2014, so that's like 2 years ago, and I was reading through all of them, and as I was reading them, they were just shooting back into my mind. I could see exactly what was happening, and it was just, I guess you could say it was a feeling of nostalgia. And so I thought I would read through them. Some of them are a little bit wacky, but I hope that they're entertaining a bit. And so yeah, let's just get into it. So some of these are very well labeled, and some of them are very well written, while other ones are like a paragraph long, and I can barely read it myself. So, the first entry, if I start reading like I don't know what words are, it's most likely because I can't read it, but let's just get into it. So, my family was at the Polish family's house with the tall girls. It's basically a family relative, and they have like these really tall daughters. Which is weird because their parents are pretty short. And there was this strange Polish people, including another Polish family, me and my brother. And we all went upstairs, and the house felt familiar, but it was very messy. I remember there was a broken light bulb on the floor in the room. There were these two other kids. And I remember they were, like, throwing Lego blocks at us. And so that was a little bit odd. It says just talking. So after talking for a little bit, me and my brother went downstairs to join one of our friends, Chris, and two of his friends. They were playing some sort of game on, like, the Xbox. And after the game was done, we went to a big but old park, which turned out to be where his cult gathered. When we got there, they had a ceremony which accepted my brother into their group. And so I was very confused, and so I kind of hung back and followed my friend Chris through the city. And I asked him some questions about it, because, you know, everyone just seemed so completely okay with it. But I remember the park was this old, creaky park in, like, the middle of, like, this abandoned factory area. There were these wooden bleachers, and they were all, like, circled around in the middle, kind of allowing my brother to join their cult. And so I followed Chris. And I found out that in his cult, people gave gifts to their queen, quote-unquote. Sometimes rather creepy gifts, like a person's toe, like Chris gave at one point. By the end of the conversation, Chris wanted to jump some fence, but it was heavily guarded, so he took the long way and wound up in this little shop. It felt like, you know, the movie Harry Potter, like those very tiny shops that you can just squeeze into. It was like that. And so, when we got in the shop, we sat down, and Chris fell into this kind of trance, like he was a zombie. And he said he had to kill me as a gift for the queen. So obviously I ran. And at some point, I made it on the roofs, and this is the weird part, because the roofs were, like, the edges were lined with trampolines, so you could run around and bounce along the trampolines. And so I was jumping from trampoline to trampoline. And I was looking for a house because I knew it was nearby, but I couldn't really find it. And I bounced and I ran into another girl midair, and then I woke up. And so, yeah, that's a little bit of a weird one, but I thought it was much longer, pretty well written, at least as well as I wrote 2.5 years ago. So, let's see. Oh, this one's a good one. So, me and my brother had to get the car from some town, and at the time, I didn't have a driver's license, and I was working to get my G1 license. And so, I was driving for some reason, and I didn't feel comfortable with it. And we were driving down this hill in this zigzaggy kind of area, and I was pressing the brake, and it wouldn't work. The brake wouldn't work, and I kept barreling forward. And I remember I crashed a few times, but we made it overall to the place we had to get. And so we went inside the closest building we could find, but some like teenage pageant was going on. And so my brother got to the back room. There was like this beaded curtain and everything. And when we got through the curtain, I saw a lot of high school friends. There was Jenna, and she was one of the contestants. But she didn't recognize me. Like, I kept looking at her like, oh, hey. And she looked really confused, like she didn't know me. And at this point, I actually wrote, warning, my dreams don't make sense. So after that, we walked through a bog, so like a very swampish area, and we had to hop a huge fence to get one of Jacob's friends. We got there, talked, and then I noticed he had the same soccer ball seat that my sister has, and we actually started to argue about whose it was if he stole her soccer ball. It's like that soccer ball seat. And so when we decided that it was his, he actually walked us to the car. And I just remembered, I wrote in brackets here, I just remembered that he was Raj from Big Bang Theory. So we crossed the bog again and got to the fence. And as soon as we got to the fence, I of course woke up. So yeah, it's really interesting where you see people in dreams that you've seen before. So you'll only see people in dreams that you've seen before. But of course, with technology and movies and TV shows and YouTube, you really expand that horizon from just the people in your city and places you've visited to theoretically around the whole world. Which one's this one? Oh yeah, this one's a weird one. It's a short one too. So, I had a dream where a girl comes to my house and tells me my friend Keegan is having a party and that he wants me over there. I don't know why this even made sense to me, because I'm like, why would he send this random girl to tell me that there's a party? I mean, we had cell phones. And I guess that's where this makes sense. Oh yeah. So, and that a bunch of old friends were going to be there. And the girl then reveals that the true reason for her being there, or she reveals the true reason for her being there. And she asks about the night me and Claire slept together. I then have a dream that I woke up and get excited to go over to Keegan's and to see all of my old friends. After getting ready and waiting for the date of the party and for my father to drive me. I realize that Keegan invited me just in a dream, and I wake up for real. So there was a dreamception in there, and so I thought I was dreaming. Person comes to house, tells me there's a party. I wake up in the dream, in a new dream, excited to go to a party, and then I wake up again in real life. So I like that because of the build to it. Let's see what else we have here. All of these pages are just bunched together. So it's just whatever. Oh yeah, this one's pretty interesting too, and I can almost vividly see it. So this dream felt like a Doctor Who episode. It was very vivid and long. A spaceship abducted a bunch of my friends and I, and we were to follow the rules at all times, or else we would get vaporized. I remember them telling us this in a very big room with this massive, like, laser cannon in the middle, I guess to shoot any of us off. And it was just this very weird feeling, like it's something that I don't think I've ever even seen in movies. It all just looks so plastic and shiny and white and red. And at first, I was at the main room, learning all the rules, and then we went to go see a movie. So like this prison area where they had us had like movies, and like it was this very utopian kind of society, like you can have a good time, but you know, listen to all of our rules. And so we went to see a movie, and when we got there, it seemed really lame and boring. I don't remember the movie. So we went to explore the area, which is obviously forbidden, and I started thinking a lot about what was happening, and I turned to Charles and asked him if he watched Doctor Who. So my brain was kind of clicking, like, wait, this kind of seems like a dream, like a TV show. And he said, oh yeah, I watch Doctor Who. And I reminded him about the scene where the aliens, too, would disintegrate people, but really all it would do is transport people. And so a lot happened in this dream, and I just remember little bits and pieces. The store closed on us when we were exploring. No, we called. I can't read it. So we called the janitor, but all he did was rat us out. I somehow got to the podium when thousands were listening and told everyone the truth, and then I woke up. So that's kind of weird. I don't know what truth I told them. Oh, it's the truth that if you actually get disintegrated, you get sent back home. So he has this whole utopian society around the idea that if you don't listen, they kill you. But the truth is, if you be yourself, and if you don't listen, you get sent back home. So that's a pretty fantastic dream I had. I was completely okay with that. I think this is going to be the last one. And so I'll try and speak even more calmly to relax you. Okay. So Brent, Grant, Corey, and I went to my college a couple of days before class to see the campus and teachers. And we went into this teacher Grasso's class, the almighty Grasso. And it looked like a biodome. And we were told to describe the area. We mostly just joked and laughed about stuff, while I fantasized about asking the girl in front of me out. And so paint a little picture. This was a very banana-shaped room. And so you got through the banana, and then there was an open classroom. And it really felt like a jungle, like there were, except a very high quality and high in technology room, where like these domes were filled with plants, and it had a very new style architecture. And it was just a bunch of us students, you know, there to learn about the program, learn about the school. And the class ended, and it was time to hand our work in for some reason, because of course it was just an introduction to the class, it was the first day, so there couldn't have been work, but we handed in this work, and I used a plate instead of paper, the crinkled one from home, okay, so I didn't hand anything in. On our way out, we were told to grab some big free water bottles, and Brent told me to grab one for him, and when I gave it to him, he bounced the bottle off someone's head, and Grasso freaked out and told him a few lines to say in front of the class. They were all very embarrassing, in brackets. He finally got out and met us outside. We had a bunch of balls, for some reason, and he just started throwing them around angrily. I remember that one very well, too. It's all very vivid. That is why I love dreams. It's just, you think it's this weak memory, but if you map it down, you'll realize how vivid it is, how strong it is, and I'm personally a believer that our dreams are nothing really that magical, sadly, but they're simply a way for us to continually be learning, even when we're asleep, and I would personally love that if that was true, and it feels pretty true, so that, you know, even in previous times when people would be hunting and living in caves, well, when they were sleeping, they would dream about being eaten by a jaguar or building a tent and stuff like that. So they would be learning even when sleeping in this very important time. And so I think that kind of follows us back. And we have these dreams usually that relate to our life pretty well, with these almost parables teaching us what we're doing right, what we're doing wrong. And I really like to learn from these dreams, and that's why I recorded a bunch of them on paper, and that is why now I record many of them on YouTube. I stopped making them for a while. Excuse me, but I'm definitely bringing them back. I'm going to be honest, it was pretty tough because my internet here was very slow. Yeah, 0.21 gigabytes per second to upload, which would take like 6-8 hours. So instead, I would head on down to my nearby library and I would simply upload from there. But, you know, I wanted my morning dreams to be very early, so I woke up at like 5 to record them, and then by the time they rendered and I got to the library, it was like 2 o'clock, and I had a lot of stuff to do too. So it was really tricky to do, especially now with work, it's tough. So I'm waiting till tomorrow when our internet gets upgraded, and I can just pump out videos for you guys. So I hope you enjoyed this short little old dream journal run through as sort of an introduction to me bringing back the dream journals. So I hope you enjoyed, and I will see you guys tomorrow. See ya. And so I was very confused, and so I kind of hung back and followed my friend Chris through the city, and I asked him some questions about it, because, you know, everyone just seems so completely okay with it, but I remember the park was this old creaky park in, like, the middle of, like, this abandoned factory area. There were these wooden bleachers, and they were all, like, circled around in the middle, kind of allowing my brother to join their cult. And so I followed Chris, and I found out that in his cult, people gave gifts to their queen, quote-unquote, sometimes rather creepy gifts, like a person's toe, like Chris gave at one point. By the end of the conversation, Chris wanted to stop some, or jump some fence, but it was heavily guarded, so he took the long way and wound up in this little shop. It felt like, you know, the movie Harry Potter, like those very tiny shops that you can just squeeze into. It was like that. And so, when we got in the shop, we sat down, and Chris fell into this kind of trance, like he was a zombie, and he said he had to kill me as a gift for the queen. So obviously I ran, and at some point I made it on the roofs, and this is the weird part, because the roofs were like, the edges were lined with trampolines, so you could run around and bounce along the trampolines, and so I was jumping from trampoline to trampoline, and I was looking for a house because I knew it was nearby, but I couldn't really find it, and I bounced, and I ran into another girl midair, and then I woke up, and so yeah, that's a little bit of a weird one, but I thought it was much longer, pretty well written, at least as well as I wrote 2.5 years ago. So let's see. Oh, this one's a good one. So me and my brother had to get the car from some town, and at the time I didn't have a driver's license, and I was working to get my G1 license, and so I was driving for some reason, and I didn't feel comfortable with it, and we were driving down this hill in this zigzaggy kind of area, and I was pressing the brake, and it wouldn't work, and the brake wouldn't work, and I kept barreling forward, and I remember I crashed a few times, but we made it overall to the place we had to get. And so we went inside the closest building we could find, but some, like, teenage pageant was going on, and so my brother got to the back room. There was, like, this beaded curtain and everything, and when we got through the curtain, I saw a lot of, high school friends. There was Jenna, and she was one of the contestants. But she didn't recognize me. Like, I kept looking at her like, oh, hey. And she looked really confused, like she didn't know me. And at this point, I actually wrote, warning, my dreams don't make sense. So after that, we walked through a bog, so like a very swampish area. And we had to hop a huge fence to get one of Jacob's friends. We got there, talked, and then I noticed he had the same soccer ball seat that my sister has, and we actually started to argue about whose it was if he stole her soccer ball. It's like that soccer ball seat. And so, when we decided that it was his, he actually walked us to the car. And I just remembered, I wrote in brackets here, I just remembered that he was Raj from Big Bang Theory. So we crossed the bog again and got to the fence. And as soon as we got to the fence, I of course woke up. So yeah, that's really interesting where you see people in dreams that you've seen before. So you'll only see people in dreams that you've seen before. But of course, with technology and movies and TV shows and YouTube, you really expand that horizon from just the people in your city and places you've visited to theoretically around the whole world. Which one's this one? Oh yeah, this one's a weird one. It's a short one too. So, I had a dream where a girl comes to my house and tells me my friend Keegan is having a party and that he wants me over there. I don't know why this even made sense to me, is because I'm like, why would he send this random girl to tell me that there's a party? I mean, we had cell phones. And I guess that's where this makes sense. Oh yeah. So, and that a bunch of old friends were going to be there. And the girl then reveals that the true reason for her being there, or she reveals the true reason for her being there, and she asks about the night me and Claire slept together. I then have a dream that I woke up and get excited to go over to Keegan's and to see all of my old friends after getting ready and waiting for the date of the party and for my father to drive me. I realize that Keegan invited me just in a dream, and I wake up for real. So there was a dreamception in there, and so I thought I was dreaming. Person comes to house, tells me there's a party. I wake up in the dream, in a new dream, excited to go to a party, and then I wake up again in real life. So I like that because of the build to it. Let's see what else we have here. All of these pages are just bunched together. So it's just whatever. Oh yeah, this one's pretty interesting too, and I can almost vividly see it. So, this dream felt like a Doctor Who episode. It was very vivid and long. A spaceship abducted a bunch of my friends and I, and we were to follow the rules at all times, or else we would get vaporized. I remember them telling us this in a very big room with this massive, like, laser cannon in the middle, I guess to shoot any of us off. And it was just this very weird feeling, like it's something that I don't think I've ever even seen in movies. It all just looks so plastic and shiny and white and red. And at first, I was at the main room, learning all the rules, and then we went to go see a movie. So like this prison area where they had us had like movies, and like it was this very utopian kind of society. Like, you can have a good time, but, you know, listen to all of our rules. And so we went to see a movie, and when we got there, it seemed really lame and boring. I don't remember the movie. So we went to explore the area, which is obviously forbidden, and I started thinking a lot about what was happening, and I turned to Charles and asked him if he watched Doctor Who. So my brain was kind of clicking, like, wait, this kind of seems like a dream, like a TV show. And he said, oh yeah, I watched Doctor Who. And I reminded him about the scene where the aliens too would disintegrate people, but really all it would do is transport people. And so a lot happened in this dream, and I just remember little bits and pieces. The store closed on us when we were exploring. No, we called, I can't read it. So we called the janitor, but all he did was rat us out. I somehow got to the podium when thousands were listening and told everyone the truth, and then I woke up. So that's kind of weird. I don't know what truth I told them. Oh, it's the truth that if you actually get disintegrated, you get sent back home. So he has this whole utopian society around the idea that if you don't listen, they kill you. But the truth is, if you be yourself, and if you don't listen, you get sent back home. So that's a pretty fantastic dream I had. I was completely okay with that. I think this is going to be the last one. And so I'll try and speak even more calmly to relax you. Okay. So Brent, Grant, Corey, and I went to my college a couple of days before class to see the campus and teachers. And we went into this teacher Grasso's class, the almighty Grasso. And it looked like a biodome. And we were told to describe the area. We mostly just joked and laughed about stuff, while I fantasized about asking the girl in front of me out. And so I'll paint a little picture. This was a very banana-shaped room. And so you got through the banana, and then there was an open classroom. And it really felt like a jungle, like there were, except a very high quality and high in technology room, where like these domes were filled with plants, and it had a very new style architecture, and it was just a bunch of us students, you know, there to learn about the program, learn about the school. And the class ended, and it was time to hand our work in for some reason, because of course it was just an introduction to the class, it was the first day, so there couldn't have been work, but we handed in this work, and I used a plate instead of paper, the crinkled one from home, okay, so I didn't hand anything in. On our way out, we were told to grab some big free water bottles, and Brent told me to grab one for him, and when I gave it to him, bounced the bottle off someone's head, and Grasso freaked out and told him a few lines to say in front of the class. They were all very embarrassing, in brackets. He finally got out and met us outside. We had a bunch of balls. For some reason. BJ. Dreams. Hey, dreamers. Today I thought we would read through some of my old dream journal entries. As you may know, I'm very fascinated with dreams. I've been recording them for a very long time. I was cleaning out my room, just 2 days ago, and I stumbled upon a whole bundle of these. It's from 2014, so that's like 2 years ago, and, I was reading through all of them, and as I was reading them, they were just shooting back into my mind. I could see exactly what was happening, and it was just, I guess you could say it was a feeling of nostalgia. And so I thought I would read through them. Some of them are a little bit wacky, but I hope that they're entertaining a bit. And so yeah, let's just get into it. So some of these are very well labeled, and some of them are very well written, while other ones are like paragraph long, and I can barely read it myself. So, the first entry, if I start reading like I don't know what words are, it's most likely because I can't read it, but let's just get into it. So, my family was at the Polish family's house with the tall girls. It's basically a family relative, and they have like these really tall daughters, which is weird because their parents are pretty short. And there was this strange Polish people, including another Polish family, me and my brother, and we all went upstairs, and the house felt familiar, but it was very messy. I remember there was a broken light bulb on the floor in the room. There were these two other kids, and I remember they were like throwing Lego blocks at us, and so that was a little bit odd. It says just talking. So after talking for a little bit, me and my brother went downstairs to join one of our friends, Chris, and two of his friends. They were playing some sort of game on like the Xbox, and after the game was done, we went to a big but old park, which turned out to be where his cult gathered. When we got there, they had a ceremony which accepted my brother into their group.